Hello and welcome, guys. I'm Gaurav Madaan, and you're watching TechPreneurShup, episode number 3. And today we have with us Ms. Shradha Sharma, the founder of YourStory, and a very, very big knowledge repository for all the startups housed in India. Okay, so today we would be changing the kind of format we have been doing, and I would not be actually giving you an introduction, and we would try to hear the introduction right from the person who is being interviewed today. Okay, so it's gonna kind of, you know, sound like kind of a PR pitch, I understand, but let's try to see what people think of themselves and not try to judge them. Okay, so let's hear it out from Shradha. Okay, Shradha, so if I would have to ask you, narrate your entire experience or journey and tell us who Shradha Sharma is and who your story is. So please, could you do that for us?
Yeah, sure. Thank you so much for having me here. I started YourStory, now it's 6 years. I started it in September of 2008 while I was still working with CNBC. And the whole idea of YourStory was to write all the stories. And I didn't think about, you know, which kind of stories. I just knew that all of us, everyone has some story. And how do we bring that out? How do we talk about it? Because, you know, for me, since childhood, what has been very motivating is what's the intent behind what we do as a person? And all of us choose different careers, do different things, and what drives? And especially if you're starting up, if you are a person who is, you know, starting a new journey, and leaving cushion job or leaving a stable opportunity to embark on something which is so new. Why do you do that? What inspires you? What is your intent? And somewhere we could capture that in a nice way, in a very personable way, in the way and the voice of the person who is starting, and that was my intent. And back then in 2008, there was no platform like this. Honestly, I never thought about that this is going to be a business, this is what I'm going to be doing full time, but somewhere there were so many stories, and I jumped in 2009 July and started doing this full time, and till date we've told 14,000 stories. So that's my story.
You know, 14,000 stories and plus one and counting. And now what I see big story, your story as a very big knowledge repository of startups in India, and it is going to act as an asset not for just entrepreneurs to learn from, but also VCs from various countries, people who want to invest, okay, and people who are looking for a kind of competition analysis. So that there's a lot of things now coming into picture, I believe, right? If I'm not wrong.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
You know, I just wanted to say that I don't know. These are all derivatives and defaults which are coming in place, but for me, to be very, very honest, your story is a way of life. Yeah, like what I've been doing 6 years is without thinking anything. We've just been telling stories, and somewhere nobody believed that you could survive like 6 years just telling stories. And for me, it was just a personal battle. You were asking that how, like, have you done this? And it was like you can, and very much. Tell good stories. In fact, many folks in media said that, you know, you can't be writing positive stories and making a business out of it, because people at the end of the day look for sensational stories. They look for negative stories because that's the human interaction with how we consume news and information. And for me, the whole thing was, no, we will. It's like more of a sociological thing, mindset, that let's write stories. But yes, 6 years down the line, I do see that things are working out. Suddenly we have a lot of data. Suddenly we have entrepreneurs whom we covered 6 years back. They have all become big. Suddenly we see a lot of goodwill. Suddenly many VCs come to me and say that, hey, they found this company first on your story, or they met after reading on your story, or we work with them and they've invested in some companies through your story. And corporates, like you know, some of these, all these big guys, if they're looking at interesting early stage innovation, they come with us. People who are looking at developers. So yeah, all this has happened, and it's good. It's very nice. It's nice for all of us, right? So yeah, it's a lot of things happening. In fact, we are soon launching a very interesting product which I've been working on since last 4 months, And hopefully, you know, again, my attempt is, I don't know, I've not again gone after business model, but I've just gone on what I've seen in the last 6 years. Writing and telling stories, is there is still a some kind of a gap when an early stage entrepreneur has to market themselves, and how do we address this? How do we do it beautifully, differently? So something soon, and yes, of course, that will be very heavily data driven.
Let's move forward, Shradha. So what I would like to ask you, I would like to request you, if as an entrepreneur, if you could walk me through your day. Just walk me through your day. What do you do the entire day? How's the journey?
You know, so I hope you edit it and delete it and write this properly, because my day is very crazy. And I like it. You know, I like chaos. I like mess. I like disorder. I like everything which is like not seamless and stable and nice. So, you know, like in my family, there is this whole thing that, you know, I somehow attract all the tension, trauma, chaos in my life. So my whole day reflects that. There is no, I would say, routine to it, because it just, I just wake up, I don't know, whenever I wake up, it's like it starts with mails, answering mails, meeting entrepreneurs, meeting different people. Now we have a big team, ensuring that we have monthly salary and payments and everything coming. Every day in my office, there are lots of people who come. You'll see me roaming around, running around in Bangalore. Most of the time I'm late for things, so I'm running somewhere. So it's it ends up at 2:33 in the night. So very less sleep, but a lot of fun. You know, I love my days. I love every day. I just love it.
Right.
If it was not like that, I would, I don't know, I'll have anxiety attack or something like that.
Okay. So even I have a question in my list, you know, just with regard to the same thing. Where is positivity an addiction? I mean, you meet so many entrepreneurs, and when we start up as an entrepreneur, what really happens is we have so much positive energy in ourselves, and whenever we talk to someone else, we transfer that energy to another guy, to the second person who we are talking to. So is positivity becoming an addiction for you?
Yeah, I think it's a very amazing question you've asked me. I don't know. In my life, personal life, there's been a lot of moments, and a lot of moments when things have been very extremely difficult. I've had a very difficult life, and since childhood, and most recently 4 years back, there were certain personal tragedies which were very defining. I think tragedies have defined me, a lot of it, and somewhere, you know, the more pain I have seen, the more positive I have become, because I had two options to choose in life, right? I could have been like a sad, depressed, cynical, not believing in anything kind of a person, or I could become very positive. So I'm very blessed and thankful to God, or to people around me, to entrepreneurs, to everyone, because I drive my energy and positivity from the environment, and the more pain comes, the more positive I become. So yeah, I like it. It's addictive. Yes, it's addictive.
It's addictive. All right. So nice to hear the kind of thoughts you have on all the things. And as you very rightly pointed out, that pain is something that makes you evolve as an entrepreneur, or rather a person, right? So
yeah,
it's actually extracting that pain and then firing back in a very positive manner.
Yeah, so, you know, I remember in 2010, I was I was under major depression. My mother had passed away very suddenly. It was a very, very tragic, very traumatic experience. And I remember I just completely lost the desire to do anything. And you wouldn't believe that I came back to work and to do things, because there were so many entrepreneurs and they were calling, and everyone had some problem, and everyone, and suddenly I could get a healing, because I could do something for someone, right? And it's such a selfish thing that when I do something for someone, I feel healed, I feel happy, and I do it because it just makes me feel so content, happy, and positive. So yes, I would say that, and that would be my, you know, we get all these kind of business advice and product advice and everything, but somewhere at the end of the day, to me, us as people, as human beings, that is very important, you know, just healing, loving ourselves every day. Like now I practice it every morning. Hey, my day is going to be awesome. Like, you know, it's just like a psychiatric tip, which I tell, hey, my day is going to be really awesome. And then when I say that and I repeat that whole day, and you'll be surprised that my whole day is awesome. Like, it just, it's awesome and awesome and awesome. Someone will say that, oh, this is like crazy and these are all blabbering stuff. But then it just is. And whenever I meet, and hopefully you should talk to people whom I meet, they all say, oh, how come you have so much of energy and so much of drive? I have it because, you know, I work towards it every day, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. You know, I can see the energy flowing into me as well. Yeah. All right. So let's move forward. So, Shradha, next question to you is, what is your biggest asset as an entrepreneur? What is your biggest asset as an entrepreneur?
What's my biggest asset as an entrepreneur? My God, I ask all these questions. You're asking me all these questions. I don't know. I honestly don't know. I think tenacity, right? I don't give up. Like just taking from my own personal life and everything. Like if I don't give up. Things can be bad, worse, or whatever. I just keep on. I move on. Like every day, I move on. I don't let bad things affect me so much. And of course, it's not happened overnight. Like I was born like this. At least from a business perspective, I work towards it every day. And I think I've not given up. You know, your story is an example of that. 6 years, right? Doing it every day. You'll never see in the last 6 years, just go back and see my site. Every day we had stories. So in 6 years, there's been no holiday, like, oh, Sunday we won't have anything or something. And that's also a reflection of the team that I've built around me. They're also as crazy as me. And I think that's my strength, right? Not giving up. I won't.
Okay. So, not giving up and doing things consistently, even if they're not coming by in the first, at the first go, because the belief which you have, the belief which you actually have in the product or what you're doing, for you it is the power of goodness. Okay, for someone else it would be something different. But believing, having a believing and self-belief is—it's all about entrepreneurship. Is it that what you're trying to say?
Yeah, you know, I would say that for me, see, again, entrepreneurship is a derivative of the human being that we are, right? Like entrepreneurship, professional, housewife, working woman, whatever. It's like it's just one of the aspects of who we are. And for me, the quest every day is to be how to be very peaceful, how to be happy and how to spread happiness, right? Because this is one life, we're all going to die, right? And I should be happy when I'm dying, and so should you be. And if I can spread happiness and all of us can be happiness, that's most important to me. Like, you know, I just love the healing which happens when I tell someone that, hey, your idea is important, because everyone you meet will say, oh, this is not working, that is not working. But just saying that, dude, you matter, I matter, you matter. And to me, that's very powerful. And then that's what gives me the joy. And I think somewhere that defines me, right? And that's why your story, and that's why everything I do, I love people genuinely. And tomorrow you might, today you're doing this, tomorrow you might be doing something else, I might be doing something else, all of us might be doing something else. The definition of what we do might change, but definition of us as human beings and what we are will not change. And to me, I want to connect with you at that level, and that drives me, and you should connect me with me at that level. And somewhere I think we'll all be so happy and the world will be so amazing and meaningful if we are able to achieve that. Don't you think so?
Absolutely, Shradha. So connection of souls to souls, or you know, two different minds and two different hearts. It's all about human nature, and it's all about relationships and what God has created.
Yeah, and you know, I've seen so much of tragedies and death, right? When you see death so closely, then you start valuing life so much, like it's so fragile. And why should I break your heart, and why should you break my heart? Let's heal the heart. And to me, the extension is, you know, tomorrow I could have been doing, like, I just look back and I say that, oh, why did I do entrepreneurship and your story writing about startups? And I think that time there were no words also, like startups were not a big thing in 2008. The thing was, I could have done the same thing for a lot more people, right? Stories. Right? The vertical now has been like, oh, you write for startup vertical and startup journalism. But I didn't even think that. For me, when I was in media, constantly I was interacting with people who were doing their own things. And then you saw the big guys getting covered in attention. And somewhere, these guys, young guys from small towns who could not speak English well, who were coming with so much of passion, and they wanted to share. And that search they had for getting a validation, getting a hand to say that, hey, you're doing awesome. And that's why I went into this vertical. If I was working with people, you know, recently I met these amazing girls who work with this patients, cancer patients in their last stages. And you should meet them. Like, you know, they had so much of energy and power and positivity. I was like thinking, if I met more of those, I would have been writing more about them. So it's like, I just love, I don't know if I can define it, but somewhere this kind of a meaning, right, which we give to each other is primarily something that I chase. I love it.
Okay.
So, I'm getting zapped what I'm saying. So that's why I'm not the right person for this interview.
All right. So, you know, to sum up in a very short manner for the other entrepreneurs, it's more the power and belief than the positivity and the relationships that you cultivate, okay, with your peers. And we're not talking about those fake relationships or those social media relationships. Actually, you have to go to them and say to them that you actually matter. Okay, so that is what is really going to help you in the long run, and you know, help you sustain sustain and grow simultaneously. So that is how I guess if I have described it in a very brief manner what you've said. All right. So Shradha, let's move forward. Since you have been in an industry which is about writing, and internet has just started to evolve in India, I know it's a really tough game, because I'm also into the same field. But something which I wanted to know from you, since you have so much data associated with your story, so if you could just throw us some light on the government regulations or something related to, if there are any government barriers in this particular field which we need to be worried of, which we need to worry about in future or maybe today.
Yeah, you know, one thing I like is that, see, it's all very relative, right? Like, if you look at China, then we shouldn't be worried about anything, because it's restrictive. I have a friend who's working there, and you don't even get to access Google and Twitter and Facebook. They have their own equivalent of Twitter, Facebook. So that way, there are two sides to it. So today, we are exposed to a lot more which is happening outside the world. We are using those kind of things. So in a way, that's good that our government is open. I love the country that we live in. It's like the best place, I think, India to do anything. But having said that, yes, there are a lot of challenges, especially in the internet domain, and especially for the kind of business that we do, is, you know, I think it's more of a mindset thing, which is also changing, sometimes I don't understand why people go and spend money on, and still, I've worked with Times of India, I've worked with CNBC, so I've seen print, I've seen TV, and sometimes when I see for a very targeted messaging, still you go, and I've spoken to many of these big business houses and people, and they say that, hey, and you'll be surprised, some of them have answered that, hey, at the end of the day, it's also about branding, and branding comes there. To me, that remains as a big question mark, because I think branding also comes from, you know, it's not that you do a show on TV, then you get like a large mindset, like a large viewership. You can get that today online also, and that is changing. But of course, as online media, you have to constantly combat that kind of a, you know, mindset that, okay, TV is bigger, print is bigger, which is true also in a way, because numbers say that those are bigger, and that's why I these days keep tweeting about the numbers online, growing numbers, because this is also growing the fastest. But so that mindset I've seen in the last 6 years, though I would say that it's changing every year, and today we work with some of the most amazing big brands, and I see that change. Second is from a government standpoint, I would say that I was very unhappy with the service tax that came on, you know, this budget. There was this announcement of service tax again being levied on online advertising and online services. To me, that's, you know, you don't have this that in print, right? And you have it on online. Print is like the most powerful making money generating business. Online is just evolving in India, that two people have this mindset issue with online, and there also you make it restrictive and do this service tax. Government could have just given us a, like, okay, 2 years, India's internet population is going to be this much, it's going to be extremely sizable, then we can start this. So that was my, you know, I'm just thinking, I'll every day write a letter to Narendra Modi, and I'm going to tweet to him and say that, remove that. Yeah, otherwise I think it's great. You know, I think the internet is a great equalizer. Would I have been able to reach so many people if there was no internet? No. I think internet represents us Indians, like, you know, the opportunity. I like yesterday the tweet which someone get that Modi did not go to America. America came to meet Modi, right? And to me, internet is the equivalent of that, reflection of that. It gives us so much of opportunity. Today you can reach to so many people, I can reach to so many people. Like 6 years back, could we have, right? We would have to reach also, we would have been dependent on the traditional media or traditional ways of doing things. Today we have to just be ourselves, and we can reach the world.
Absolutely.
And I think entrepreneurs and all of us have to look at the positive opportunity this throws, because every day we can look at all the challenges also which are there. Of course, there are too many. Like, you know, I still think that 3G, 4G are like just notional, and internet connection, like, you know, still is a big problem, like getting great connectivity and all that. It's embarrassing sometimes when you're doing like a international Skype or something, and suddenly, you know, you just go, something happens. So those are challenges. But the point is that today we have so much of opportunity, and I've lived those years, right? And every year since 2008 to 2014, I think it's brilliant to do startup now. It's brilliant that we have internet. It's brilliant we have Twitter. I meet you. It's brilliant we have all these mediums to reach out to each other.
Right, right. So there is no dearth of opportunity. So we had Mr. Alok on our first episode, and he said that India is a heaven for entrepreneurs.
No, I don't know. I won't say heaven, because if heaven was heaven, then we would have been angels, right? Roaming around and flocking and all that. I would say heaven. Heaven is not heaven. Potholes are also there. And there is a lot. But definitely better. Every year getting better. To me, that's a great signal, right? Agar heaven hota to maza kya hota? Bhagwan banke baithe rehte hum log pravachan dete. I think it's challenging, and that's the fun, right? And it's getting better, definitely.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So, this is my view, right?
No, I would never do that. So. And by the way, I'll be waiting for the tweet, and I'm going to retweet if you say to Modi that, Mr. Modi, that why have you raised the service tax on online advertising and not on print? Right?
Yeah, so, yeah.
Even I was really upset, because I'm working in the same field. So anyways, let's move ahead, and let's try to dig in more. So Shradha, would you like to talk a bit about the product which you're building to help entrepreneurs? You know, I've seen a lot of interviews around you, your talks, saying that you're trying to connect the Silicon Valley as well, and trying to leverage you know, the resources over there to help entrepreneurs in India. So if you would like to throw some light on that, I would be really, really excited.
I can just tell you that it's going to be fun. It's not going to be jazz and bullshit and I've also learned last 4 months. I've just worked very hard and learned what a product is, right? Because we read everything, but once you start doing something, then you realize kitna mehnat hai. So it's my personal one of the challenges. You know, you will not believe. Like when I was on Twitter, see, I think I joined in 2010. Someone helped me create my account, and I was not even there. I just now started tweeting and all that kind of stuff. So mera us samay when I used to see no people with like 1 million followers and all that kind of followers, I wish that guy with 1 million followers can retweet about your story, right? Then suddenly it will go to 1 million people and they'll get to know. And, you know, like a desperate soul, I used to just wish, but I didn't have the guts to be like so shameless and say, oh, can you please? And second, whenever I did that after amassing all the kind of guts, nobody did that for me, right? कोई बड़ा आदमी नहीं रिट्वीट कर रहा था ये वो काइंड ऑफ स्टफ तो मैंने ये सोचा दैट इवन समवन लाइक मी हु एटलीस्ट हैड अ बेस लेवल ऑफ सो मेनी पीपल आई न्यू एंड नेटवर्क्स एंड एवरीथिंग हैड अ चैलेंज इन टर्म्स ऑफ द रीच आउट आई डिड टू माय एंड target audience whom I wanted to reach out to. I still had problems in spite of having networks, in connecting to users, customers, getting money, and to me that is an interesting question. And I'm just thinking that even if I can help like 1,000 entrepreneurs, right, like yeah, 500. अपने आप को और 500 बाकी लोगों को अगर हम इंडिया सिलिकॉन वैली पूरे वर्ल्ड से इन अ वेरी स्मार्ट वे विद कस्टमर्स एंड यूजर्स वी कैन कनेक्ट एंड इट्स गोइंग टू बी लाइक अ शेयर्ड इकोनॉमी राइट इफ आई लाइक इट्स लाइक इन ट्विटर टर्म आई वुड से दैट इफ यू ट्वीट फॉर मी आई ट्वीट फॉर यू right kind of stuff. See, today anyone who writes to me, I don't have any much followers, but whoever sends, can you retweet in the make second can then retweet kar dete, right? Like unless it's like something scandalous, if anyone says retweet, I do it because I've lived that right dream ki mera bhi koi kar deta. So this product is going to be based on this. We're getting people from all over. It's going to be interesting, but the whole underpin of this product is that how do you get more customers, how do you get more users in a very positive way? So it's going to be exciting.
All right. So by the feel of it, I could say it's exciting. So when can we expect it, you know, coming out?
I will send you the email of this next week. You check it and give me all the feedback and everything.
Absolutely. Critics are important, right?
Yeah. Before maybe sab bajane lage. ट्विटर ये सब पे मैं तुम्हें सेपरेटली सबको भेज दूंगी कुछ कुछ लोगों को यू गाइस गिव फीडबैक बिफोर इट बिकम्स नॉइजी
एब्सोल्युटली एब्सोल्युटली नोबडी इज गोइंग टू यू नो पुट यू आफ्टर ऑल दोस वर्क यू हैव पुट इनटू दिस प्रोडक्ट नोबडी इज रियली गोइंग टू यू नो फायर ऑन यू लाइक इट डिड ऑन टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया रिसेंटली विद द दीपिका पादुकोण डिबेकल सो इट्स नॉट गोना हैपन रिलैक्स ओके सो
Yeah, but I am with Deepika Padukone. I love her and endorse whatever views she has.
Yeah, so the Times of India is the sufferer, not Deepika. Deepika is on the upper hand, rather. I also support her in a very positive manner.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's move ahead, Shradha. So, you know, if you have to give, to summarize your entire life into two learnings, two biggest learnings, okay, for all the viewers watching out. So how would you do that? I mean, make it practical, make it short so that they can consume it and benefit from it.
You know, so in Hindi, I say this very regularly, doge to milega, right? Sometimes as entrepreneurs we start seeking because we have so many challenges we have to seek right but give it will not go wasted and give it to everyone to all your stakeholders be it your VCs embrace just go and hug your VCs go and hug your investors they also need love and affection just give learn to give you'll be surprised how much you will get, and it will be insane the amount you will get. I really believe that. I'm a testimony. My life is a testimony of that. One. Second thing is, you know, the really believe, have a great sense of humor. Right? Take anything seriously, because life is otherwise too serious and tragic, right? I believe all these philosophers of Renaissance age, that they were saying it's all about tragedy and melancholy. So be humorous, because it's going to be very tough. It's going to be, I really believe it is very lonely, and it is depressing. But be, have a sense of humor. You'll be like crazy. You know, nobody can beat you. Your humor will be the biggest asset that you can have. Just joke about it. Like, you know, I joke about everything. Like, anything negative I hear, like, and I joke about it. You know, we have like great sense of humor in my team, and we laugh about everything. So these two things, you'll be, and you know, I've traveled last year to different parts and gone to different places, sought after hubs of entrepreneurship, and somewhere I saw firsthand through my own eyes things like these happening. People give, and that's why the ecosystem and things evolve, right? And right. You might say that he had nothing to give, but you'll be surprised. All of us are born, and we are breathing, and we have so much to give. So please do, as entrepreneurs, and be whatever you want will happen, I think.
All right. So it's more like give so that you can have it back. Okay. So it's. So don't do it with the agenda, but be truthful, and from the real inside, you have to give back to the entire universe, and the universe will shower their blessings on you. So that is what Shraddha has for us. All right, guys. And the second most important thing which she conceptualizes and gives it back to you is be humorous, because fun is universal. It does not need a language to even express. Even your emotions or even your expressions can convey what fun is. Okay, and it is good. Life is going to be tough, so make sure that it's humorous enough, and you don't get into those dark zone or the get stuck with those particular zones. All right. So that's all we have from Shraddha. Thank you so much, guys, and thank you so much, Shraddha, for joining us. And we are really, really glad to have a word with you. And I hope, and I wish you all the very best for your coming product. And trust me, I'm going to be a critic.
I want you to be critic so that I can laugh about it. And at the same time, I can learn from it. Thank you so much for having me. It was wonderful. Absolutely. Yeah.